Hi everyone, welcome to IIS by Heart. Myself Sasti Kumar, and this is our prelims HEST series, one stop solution to crack prelims. And this is our first environment class prelims discussion, and today we are going to discuss about 10 prelims questions. This is our first question. Which of the following statements about ecology is correct? Option A, ecology is the study of animals. Option B, ecology was founded in the 1700s. Option C, ecology is the study of the interactions among organisms and their environment. D, none of the above. In the statements, ecology is not only about the study of animals, it is about the study of the interaction among the animals. So option A is wrong. Option B, ecology was founded in 1700s. No, this is the wrong answer. Ecology was founded in 1869 by Ernst Haeckel. The term was coined by Ernst Haeckel. So our option, our answer is C. Ecology is the study of interaction among the organisms and their environment. The explanation is, according to him, oikos means home and ology means study. Simply means study of house of the living organisms. It is a study of a relationship between organisms and their environment. So in some cases, students are little bit difficult to find the difference between environment and ecology. So in our next slide, we will discuss about environment and ecology. First one, ecology. See here, ecology is a smaller concept when compared to environment. So ecology is a study of relationship between organisms and their environment. But here environment, it interact between both physical, chemical as well as biological components. So environment is a broader field. It includes all the elements of earth and life. Ecology is usually focused on how organisms interact with each other and their surrounding. Environment refers to the sum of total living as well as non-living components. Here, in ecology, the competition between the population size, diversity and distribution of organisms are the major issues. But in environment, deforestation, global warming and pollution are the major issues. Now, our second question. Which of the following articles of the Indian Constitution are related to environment? Option 1, Article 21. Option 2, Article 48A. Option 3, Article 51AG. This Article 21, it's our fundamental right. And Article 48A, this is our directive principle of state policy. And Article 51AG, this is our fundamental duty. Here, we have to choose the correct option from the given code. Here we are all know about that Article 48A and Article 51AG are talks about environment. Article 48A talks about protection and improvement of environment and safeguarding of forest and wildlife. Article 51AG, that's our fundamental duty to protect and improve the natural environment including forest, lakes, rivers and wildlife. But in Article 21, here there is a lot of confusion because this article talks about right to life and personal liberty. But this Article 21 is an inferred right. That is nothing but this is the most evolved article of the Constitution. It talks about environment and ecology also. In the case of Subhash Kumar and versus State of Bihar case, Supreme Court held that right to life under Article 21 of the Constitution is a fundamental right and it includes the right to free water and free air from pollution for the full enjoyment of life. So this Article 21 also includes environment and ecology part. So our option is D. All the above. 1, 2, 3. Then our third question is, Amrabat Tiger Reserve was recently in news. Consider the following statements in this regard. here our option is, it is the India's largest tiger reserve, lies in Nallamala Hills, Telangana. Second one, it is inhabited by Aboriginal Chenchu tribe. Third one, mouse deer has been reintroduced in the forest of Nallamala in Amrabad Tiger Reserve. Fourth one, the Chenchus are scheduled tribes in the Indian states of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Here, see this first option. This Amrabad Tiger Reserve is not the largest tiger reserve. So, this option is wrong. Second one, it is inhabited by Aboriginal Chenchu tribe. This is a right statement. So, second one is a right statement. Third one, recently mouse deer has been reintroduced in this forest of Nallamala. So, this is also a right statement. And fourth one, the Chenchus are the scheduled tribes in the Indian state of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. This is a wrong one. So, our option is B, that is 2 and 3. So, here is our explanation. See here, Amrabad Tiger Reserve is lies in Nallamala Hills of Telangana. Okay. It is the second largest tiger reserve, next only to the Nagarjuna Sagar Sthisailam Tiger Reserve. So, Nagarjuna Sagar Sthisailam Tiger Reserve is the largest tiger reserve. And Amrabad Tiger Reserve is the second largest tiger reserve. So, here, see the first statement. It is the largest tiger reserve. So, this is a wrong statement. And then, it has a wildlife like leopard, sloth bear, wild dog, spotted deer, sambar and wild boars. The endangered species of mouse deer was reintroduced here. So, this statement also right. The third statement also right here. This Amrabad is dominated by the Chenchus tribe. But, these Chenchus tribes are lives in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka and Odisha. But, in our question, we are mentioned about Chenchus are scheduled tribe in the Indian state of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So, this is a wrong statement. So, our answer is option B. That is 2 and 3. See here, this is some news about Amrabad Tiger Reserve. So, this Amrabad Tiger Reserve was earlier a part of Nagarjuna Sagar Sthisailam Tiger Reserve. But some part of time after it was bifurcated. The reserve created with areas in Mahabubnagar and Nalgonda district. And one important thing is, this Amrabad Tiger Reserve having uranium mines. See here. So please note this point. So this Amrabad Tiger Reserve has some uranium mines. So, Chenchus tribe. These Chenchus are particularly vulnerable tribal group. Please note this point. Take a A4 sheet and please write a list of particularly vulnerable tribal group. This is very important for our UPSC examination. And then second one. These Chenchu tribes are the forest dwellers whose hamlets or penta dots the Nallamala forest range spread across 4 to 5 districts in the Telangana and the Andhra Pradesh state. Their economy was based on hunting and gathering. One important flower is there, Mahua flower. These Chenchus tribe make use of these Mahua flower for making of liquor. These Chenchus talks the Chenchu language. This Chenchu language is a member of Dravidian language family. See, these are the Chenchus tribe people. So, our next question is, consider the following statement regarding emission gap report 2019. First statement, emission gap report is released by UNEP. Greenhouse gas emission have risen at a rate of 1.5% per year in the last decade. Third statement, G7 nation collectively account for 78% of all emissions. So here we have to choose the correct code. And this question we are going to solve by on the basis of elimination method. See here, G7 nations collectively account for 78% of all the emissions. This G7 nations is nothing but these are the peoples of group of 7 international and intergovernmental economical organizations which consist of US, France, Italy, Japan, UK, Germany. So these nations collectively account for 78% of all the emissions. That means nothing but excluding India and China. But in real scenario, India and China are one of the most important contributed in our global countries. So this statement was wrong. So here is our explanation for this. G20 nations collectively account for 78% of all the emissions. But in here our statement, G7 nations collectively account for 78% of all our emissions. That means this third statement is a wrong statement. See here, please eliminate this third one. Our C option will get eliminated and B option will get eliminated, as well as D also gets eliminated. So the remaining option is A, 1 and 2. So we have to pick this answer in a very first manner. See here, recently UNEP launched 10th edition of Emission Gap Report 2019. In this report, they are given a rate of 1.5% per year in the last decade. Greenhouse gas emission have risen. So that's the crux of the report. This report also talks about G20 nations collectively account for 78% of all the emissions. In that one, the top 4 emitters are China, USA, European Union and India. These 4 emitters contribute 55% of total emission over last decade. This is our additional point about UNEP program. UNEP is a leading global environment authority. This UNEP sets some global environmental agenda, and also not only set global environment agenda but also promote that implementation of that agenda. Its headquarters is located in Kenya, Nairobi. This UNEP have voluntary contribution for 95% of its funding. It depends on 95% of its voluntary contribution of funding. And this UNEP was founded in 1972. Its mandate covers a wide range of areas, including the atmosphere, marine and terrestrial ecosystems. UNEP's activities include developing international environmental convention, promoting environmental science and information. So this is about United Nations Environment Program. Our next question is, Araku Valley was recently in news. Consider the following statements in this regard. First one, it is located in state of Andhra Pradesh. Second one, Araku Valley is known for its tea cultivation, which recently got GI tag. choose the correct code. In these two statements, we all know that Araku Valley is located in the state of Andhra Pradesh. But in the second statement, Araku Valley is known for its tea cultivation. This is the wrong one, because Araku Valley is known for its coffee plantation. So by eliminating second one, first one is the right answer. First statement is the right answer. So our option is A. So here is our explanation. Araku Valley is a hill station situated at Andhra Pradesh. So this is our first statement. Second one, it is known for its coffee production, not for tea production. So our second statement is wrong. And then this Araku Valley has won gold medal for the best coffee pod in the Prix Epictures or 2018 awards in Paris. This Araku Valley Arabica coffee can be described as a coffee from the hilly tracts of Visakhapatnam. See, this is Araku Valley. This coffee, this Arabica coffee, which is produced by the tribal group. This tribal group follow a substantial use of organic manures as well as organic pest management practices. They are using a purely organic approach. So there will be a very huge demand for this coffee varieties. This is a map for major coffee producing states. The major coffee producing states are Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. These are the coffee producing areas of India. Please take a map and note these places so that it will be useful for our prelims. Then our next question, consider the following statements regarding Kushum scheme. Our first statement is, Union Ministry of Water Resource, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation has issued operational guidelines for the implementation of Kushum scheme. Second statement is, the scheme aims to provide energy security along with financial and water security to farmers. Third statement, it targets to add decentralized solar power capacity of 27,750 megawatt by 2022. In this question, we have to select the correct code. In first sentence, this Union Ministry of Water Resource, this is a wrong one, because this Kushum scheme was implemented under the guidelines of Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So our first statement is wrong. And second statement, the scheme aims to provide energy security along with the financial and water security to farmers. This is the right statement. Third also right statement. So 2 and 3 is our right answer. So B is our answer. So here is our explanation. Ministry of New and Renewable Energy issued a operational guidelines for the implementation of Kushum scheme. So our first statement will be wrong. So we have to eliminate that one. And second one, the scheme aims to provide energy security along with financial and water security to farmers. So this is a right statement. So second statement will be right. It would also encourage farmers to generate solar power in their farms itself, and by using this clean energy, they replace their diesel water pumps. See here, this is the application of Kusum scheme. They are placing some solar panel near to their field itself. By using this solar panel, they are producing solar energy. By using this solar energy, they are irrigated their lands. So this is a clean energy. Next question. Consider the following statements. First one, the interaction where one species is benefited and the other is neither benefited nor harmed is called commensalism. Second statement, in amensalism, one species is harmed whereas the other is unaffected. Which of the above statement is or correct? Here, this is more conceptual oriented question. In order to understand this question, see here, commensalism. Commensalism is nothing but plus and zero. For example, see here, the interaction where one species is benefited means this is a, it has a plus symbol. One species benefited means plus symbol. Other species neither benefited nor harmed means zero. One species is harmed means negative. For example, means that's my negative growth. If I am getting benefit or some benefits means that's my positive growth. If I am getting neither benefit or nor harmed means that's my zero, that's my neutral point. So here neutral is zero and benefited is positive, harmed is negative. So the interaction where one species is benefited and the other is neither benefited nor harmed, that means plus and zero. See here, commensalism means plus and zero. In amensalism, one species is harmed whereas the other is unaffected, that is negative and zero. See here, negative and zero. So both statements are right. So our option is C. For example, in commensalism, vultures feeding on dead animals. Here, vultures getting benefited. That means vulture getting positive interaction, whereas this dead animal neither getting benefited nor getting affected. So that's a neutral point, so zero. So this is an example of commensalism. In amensalism, take example of equatorial rainforest. In equatorial rainforest, big trees with the excess canopy, it restricts the sunlight of small plants. So here big trees, it neither getting benefited nor getting affected. So it is a zero neutral point, but it restricts the sunlight to the small plants. That means this small plants getting negatively affected. So this is called amensalism. One more example, wild animals walking over grass. Here wild animals neither getting benefited nor getting harmed, but this grass affected by this wild animal. So this is called amensalism. So next question, with reference to the fall armyworm, which of the following statement is or correct? It is a native species of India. It is a dangerous transboundary insect with a high potential to spread. It is a real threat to food security and livelihoods of millions of smallholders, farmers by spreading across all of sub-Saharan Africa and Near East and Asia. Choose the correct code. Here, this fall armyworm is not a species of India. It is a species of America. So it is an invasive species. So, but this second statement and this third statements are right statement. It is a dangerous insect. It is also having a real threat to food security and affect millions of livelihoods. So, by eliminating the first one, we are getting our option as B. And this is our explanation. It is an invasive species of native of America. The scientific name of this species is Spodoptera frugipedra. This is also a dangerous boundary insect with high potential to spread. And this represents a real threat to food security and it affects livelihoods of millions of smallholder farmers. See, this is that FAW. This FAW can be controlled through integrated pest management activities. This point can be useful for our mains answer writing. So please make a note. And this Food and Agriculture Organization has launched a global action for this FAW control. So our next question is, arrange the following in decreasing level of organization in ecology. First one, population, biosphere, community, biome, ecosystem. In order to understand this one, please see this diagram. This is an individual. This is a population. Population means a group of species. Community means a group of species interacting with other species. So here is our definition. Individual means it is an organism has the ability to act or function independently. So this will act and function independently. And second is our population is a group of organisms, usually of same species. This is the important one. And community is a it is a group of individuals of one species. It depend upon the individuals of other species. That is nothing but one species interact with another species is called as our community. So this is our community. One species interacting with the other species. And then ecosystem. Ecosystem is nothing but the it is a structural and functional unit of biosphere. It consisting of living things as well as physical environment. And biome. Biome is nothing but terrestrial part of biosphere. And biosphere. Biosphere is a part of Earth where life can exist. So this is our diagram. So here our question is arrange this one in our decreasing format. So our first one is biosphere, second one is biome, third one is ecosystem, fourth one is community, and fifth one is population. So our option is A. And our last question, Gadgil committee report and Kasturirangan committee report sometimes seen in the news are related to, this is a direct question. Option D, protection of Western Ghats. See here, this committee was formed by Union Government. This is because of due to some rapid loss of Western Ghats, ecological character loss due to encroachment and mismanagement. So only Union Government of India formed this committee for conservation and protection of Western Ghats. So this is encroachment of Western Ghats. So that's the end of our session. Thank you so much for your valuable time. Thank you so much.